Track came a hobo hiking, and he said, "Boys, I'm not turning. I'm headed for a land that's far away, beside the crystal fountains. So come with me, we'll go and see the Big Rock Candy Mountains. In the Big Rock Candy Mountains, there's a land that's fair and bright, where the handouts grow on bushes, and you sleep out every night. Where the boxcars all are empty, and the sun shines every day. On the birds and the bees and the cigarette trees, the lemonade springs where the bluebird sings in the Big Rock Candy Mountains. In the Big Rock Candy Mountains, all the cops have wooden legs, and the bulldogs all have rubber teeth, and the hens lay soft-boiled eggs. The farmer's trees are full of fruit, and the barns are full of hay. Oh, I'm bound to go where there ain't no snow, where the rain don't fall, the wind don't blow, in the Big Rock Candy Mountains. In the Big Rock Candy Mountains, you never change your socks, and the little streams of alcohol come a-trickling down the rocks. The brakemen have to tip their hats, and the railroad bulls are blind. There's a lake of stew and a whiskey too. You can paddle all around them in a big canoe in the Big Rock Candy Mountains. In the Big Rock Candy Mountains, the jails are made of tin, and you can walk right out again as soon as you are in. There ain't no short-handled shovels, no axes, saws, or picks. I'm a-going to stay where you sleep all day, where they hung the Turk that invented work in the Big Rock Candy Mountains. I'll see you all this coming fall in the Big Rock Candy Mountains.
Daddy played the banjo neath the yellow tree. It rang across the backyard, an old-time melody. I loved to hear the music, I was only five. I listened as his fingers made the banjo come alive. Sometimes I'd wake up at night and hear a distant tune. Banjo would echo around my childhood room. I'd sneak down the back stairs, Daddy never knew. I'd grab a broom and make believe I was picking tunes. One day Daddy put my fingers down upon the strings. He picked it with his other hand, we made the banjo ring. Now the music takes me back across the yellow days, to the summers with my dad and the tunes he played. Thank you. just telling lies about the things I did. See, I'm that banjo player who never had a kid. Now I sit beneath that yellow tree, hoping that a kid somewhere is listening to me. Daddy played the banjo.
Did you get any better footage if you stood in the back with me?
Yeah, I'm going to hang out in the back this time.
I can let you stand in the back. I mean, not on the back of the train, but you can stand here in the back.
Yeah.
If you're over 18.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
Cool with you.
I'm over 100.
You see this bay right here on the right side?
Yeah.
I'll have you stand right in there with me.
Okay.
130, here you go.
All right, folks, please remain seated and enjoy the ride down. And I don't even mind if you stick it out the window. If you drop it, it's gone though. But you can
hang it. I ain't gonna drop it. $500 camera.
Yeah.
I ain't gonna drop it.
Pennsylvania 2 years ago. This one and the other one together. $9 million.
How much?
$9 million.
Oh, you were gonna do that to other people.
They came with a 1 year warranty.
1 year warranty.
I'm dead serious.
Actually, that's the cable from the other
track. That is true. Oh, there's a bunch on there. There's a lot. What that sound is of the cables from the other train sliding against the side of ours. We have buffer bars over there to deflect the impact of it. It's unavoidable because we go from two tracks down to one singular track.
Yeah.
It puts that ever so slightly degree of an angle on it. And the tension on such a steep slope lifts that cable up because of the pull on it. It's impressive to me that the cables are heavy enough that they actually lay down at all. You would think it would just be a straight line from the top station, but they're heavier than the trains are, the cables.
Yeah, when the trains cross each other, is that the halfway point?
Yeah, exactly halfway.
Okay.
Because this is the funicular. As you notice, he doesn't attach to the train.
That's the job to have.
He comes off behind the train. We own the track at 15 feet to each side of it. And we have to manicure that.
So, at night, it's just like...
So, on Halloween and like Christmas, we don't do anything officially on our end. A lot of the homeowners next to the train will, though. They'll put up Halloween decorations along the track. Sometimes they come out in like costumes for Halloween and Christmas. Christmas, we had a lady stand out there in her driveway for almost 3 hours in a reindeer costume, dancing each time the train come past. A lot of people get infested with it that live near the train, but we don't do anything on our end. These trains get up to like 130 in the summer inside. This ain't the greenhouse on wheels, which is why they're wanting to put the awning over it to help it down here.
Yes.
This is where most of the heat comes from.
Yes.
Yeah, but it gets hot.
Thanks.
You're welcome. You guys have a great day.
Okay, John.